Well, the fireball came in on the 27th of November. We got through that camera, that list of different fireballs, because we see them all the time. So we realized that was a big one a few days later. Then everything kind of clicked into action when we realized there was probably a rock on the ground. We sent a couple of guys out to get on a little spotter plane to get a first look at it. They saw a feature on the lake that looked like where it might have hit. We knew we had to get there before there was any more rain. But it's the middle of the, you know, it's the holidays, right? So you're trying to organize all this stuff and, you know, shops are shut and the university's shut. We had to get authorization from the indigenous people in that area, the Arabana people. And they were amazing. You know, they were actually, they sorted it out for us quicker than anyone else, and which was fantastic. And a couple of those people, Dean Stewart and Dave Strangway, came with us as guides, and they were a huge help. Unfortunately, between the first guys going out and taking a picture and then us getting out there, it was only 2 weeks, but there'd been a lot of rain in that time. So part of the lake had filled up, and we knew that that would have an effect on that first, that little crater that you can see on some of those first images, and that was an issue. Then more rain was gonna come in as well. So that was, you know, there was a clock ticking. We couldn't find it, and that was quite disappointing. So, you know, you go all the way out of this place, you throw all these resources at it, you've organized it all over Christmas and the New Year when you really want to be home with your family, you know, and we couldn't see it. And the kind of final attempt of looking from the air while we're on the ground was literally that. You know, we knew that the weather was coming in and that was going to be the last gasp. So the plane was circling for at least an hour, and it was starting to rain, and me and Robert out in the middle of the lake with the quad bikes, you don't want to be on one of the biggest mud baths in the world in the rain ever. So it was really touch and go, you know, how long do we stay? And then the guys say, okay, we've seen it. But then they lose it again, right? So they're flying around more, and I'm looking at them, and they're nowhere near where they said they saw it. And I've run out to that spot, but you're running through mud, so it's actually really knackering. And then finally they spot it again, and then I see the thing, but you're still not sure, and I'm still not sure until finally my fingers touched it at the bottom of this dirty great hole, and that was quite a nice moment.
It's a 9 meteorite, mate.
It's amazing being a planetary geologist. I love it. I mean, my job is to study the origins of the solar system, and when I'm lucky, running around looking for rocks from space. So I couldn't wish to do anything better.